Hello ji, welcome back to next one. In this session we are going to have a walkthrough of a Test Sigma no code automation framework. So let me go through the Test Sigma side. Here you can see the login button, and once you are clicking on the login button, basically you will navigate to the dashboard. You have to enter the login details and all these things. This is how dashboard of Test Sigma look like. Before moving forward, don't forget to like and share this video with your friend, and don't forget to subscribe Fundo Testers.
Camera rolling, action.
So basically this is a dashboard of a Test Sigma. Here we are going to write our automation script in a plain English. We can see here they have provided a list of various projects. So if you are working on a multi project, we can create a multiple project. So here I have created a multiple project by clicking on a simple new project. We can create a new project, and here I have created a various project like for a mobile, for Android application, iOS application, and various projects are available. So here we have a various number of scripts. So here we can see in a detail mode, whoever has a credential of this platform in our team, so they can go through the how many test cases are fail, how many test cases are executed, and if those are failing, then what can be the reason. And apart from they want to go through the videos or any other things, they can easily go on through. Here we can see the test case status voice breakup, test case type voice breakup. So all this information we can see in a graphical view, and from here we can add a new test cases, new requirement, version, application, or a project also we can create. And they have listed the tutorials as well. Those are pretty nice tutorials. So if we are using this platform and we stuck at any point, then we can go through the tutorials as well. And apart from in a side panel, so we can see the various options. So basically this is the dashboard. And from here we can go through the test case development. In test case development, this is how it looks. So whatever test cases we have developed, all the test cases will look like this. And we can go through the any test cases, and we can see the script here. So if I go to the any test script, this is how it looks. So we are going to write in a simple English. So here it's like navigate to particular URL, then enter this data to this field, that data to that field, and then click on the login button. So simply that's how it is done. And we can reorder the step if we want to add any steps in between. Then also we can do the things here. There is a way to launch debugger. So in debugging mode we can execute our test. We can click on the run. So if you are clicking on a run button, we can see here the various options. We are going to run on a Test Sigma lab, local devices, source lab, browser stack, lambda test. We can select the OS, so we can see here Windows OS, Mac OS, Linux OS, because what happens in real time, we are going to make sure that whatever the test we have performed, those should run against each and every environment, because we don't know user is going to use which OS, which applications. So that's why as a tester we have to test application against all the different browsers, OS. Here we can see the OS. If you are going to select the Windows, then again we can see the Windows 10, 8.1, 8.7, because in real time what happens, we will not have those number of a device in organization. Let's say we are using a Mac machine, then simply we will have a one Mac machine, or means all the team has a Mac machine, and maybe they have a two or three different OS. So what about a different OS? How we are going to execute the test again different OS? And here we can execute test on a different browser. So they have listed the major browsers here: Safari, Firefox, Chrome. And for example, let's say I'm going to select a Google Chrome, then I can see here the different version of a Google Chrome. So no need to uninstall or install in our real device. This all are easily available, and we can execute on against any resolution. They have listed some standard resolutions here. So based on that we can execute our test, and they have provided some additional settings here for each and every element. We can apply different types of weight. So this all things we will see in a further tutorials in detail. and we can execute the test, and end of the execution we will have a screenshots, and we will have a screen recording video, we will get a mail, and entire our team will have a mail of a test case execution report. So this is the wonderful tool, I would say. And if I go back, basically we have to write a element. So here we can write element by own, or we can record the elements. So this is again classic functionality apart from test data profile. So in real time we have to go through the so much coding, so much advanced coding for managing a test data, but here we can easily manage the test data. Then custom function, as I said, if I want to do something else and I want to write some specific function, then here can be done. We can see the requirement here, test suite, test plan, run test. So basically in real time, let's say we have different test suites like a smoke test, regression test. So we can create a bunch of a test plan, we can create a bunch of test suites. So all this can be managed here, and environment details and all these things we will get here. And next, if I go to the project setting, here whatever settings I wanted to do, I can do here. So number of projects I have can listed here, apart from the which are the applications I am going to test. So it is not like that this is for one application. If in my organization, let's say there are multiple projects or multiple applications, so I can automate all the applications using a single platform apart from project member. So I can define a project member name here, and I can define the basically name, email ID and role, and based on that we can see we can enable the member, so they can directly come to project and they can see what is happening inside the project and what is the status of automation. Apart from requirement type, we can track the requirement, we can track a test cases, we can test cases priority, we can decide here. So all these things, let's say in our organization we have P1, P2, or in some organization they are referring to critical blocker or measure. So this can be managed here. And apart from in settings, you can see here they have provided various plugins. So this is the all the plugins. This is the really amazing. We can integrate our automation with anything, like you can see X-Ray, Trello, SourceLab, BrowserStack. So simply we just need to enable in a one click, and we can integrate our automation with particular plugins. So here number of plugins are available. Apart from iOS settings or various settings we have to go through. So this all the things can be done here. So for bug reporting also they have different tool. Collaboration, they have different tools. TestLab, they have BrowserStack integration, SourceLab. So in real time we have to go on through the APIs and we have to write so much code. So here we can leverage all these things without writing any code. And project manager, yeah, obviously we are integrating our test with Azure DevOps or Jira. So all these are available here. And CI/CD, so AWS, which is the latest Azure DevOps if someone is going to use on a C# infra. So whatever we can think can be utilized here without writing a single line of code, easily can be done. And if I go down, so here we can see that is a help button. So there I can see get started, means in detailed documentation, video tutorials, documents. So all these things are listed here. So if I'm going to a documentation, so here they have maintained proper way, industry standard document. Here you can find all these things. Looking for some integration like a bug reporting tool and you want to integrate with the Jira, they have provided a industry standard documentation. Here you can just go through and you can find a ways to integrate with various tools and plugins. So this is how Test Sigma looks. In next tutorial we are going to write our first script to automate login functionality of a web application. So before moving forward, don't forget to like and share this video with your friends. And if you have any doubts, yeah, please ask me in a comment section. I will be happy to answer. And don't forget to like and don't forget to subscribe Fundo Testers. Stay tuned. Thank you.